So I pick up this rock, and I think this rock is maybe like an uncut diamond, like the biggest in the world. And I think about how it could be polished and finished off, and it could be one or two or maybe three diamonds and be spectacular. But it could also be destroyed. The gemologists could make mistakes. They could maybe not get it right, and the thing would be smashed to smithereens and be pretty much worthless. I think about that uncut diamond, and I look at this land, at this basically virgin kind of farmland that the city of Mesquite has annexed nearly 4 square miles along both sides of I-20. And I think about how they're gonna develop this property. On the one hand, the city can allow developers to take the money and run. They could allow this land to be developed with tract homes, strip malls, lots of traffic, and acres of concrete parking. On the other hand, they could foster the creation of a community, of a one-of-a-kind place like this, where people can come to live and to work and to enjoy themselves, where the whole is much greater than the sum of the parts and contributes a whole lot more to the future and the sustainability of the city. City Manager Cliff Cahilly wanted to amp up the conversation. He wanted to include landowners, other citizens in the city, in order to figure out what to do with this land. And he wanted a conversation that would be totally neutral. He didn't want to have the inside the city city planners. He didn't want to have outside the city the traditional architects and planners that work for design firms or architecture firms. He wanted something that was totally neutral, something he could stand behind as he took the results to the city council. The concept is called placemaking. In the private and not-for-profit sector, it's called design thinking. We brought landowners, business owners, and homeowners together for a two-day workshop. So what is placemaking? It's really about creativity. It's about a human-centered approach to innovation and to design, leveraging arts, culture, and family activities. It really asks first whether the design is desirable. What do people want or need? It then moves to asking about viability and feasibility. Should we do it? Can we do it? What makes a great place? 4 key attributes to consider: uses and activities, comfort and image, access and linkages, and sociability. So for the process to be effective, you need to have a variety of people in the room from all sorts of different backgrounds. They need to be able to collaborate for buy-in. They need to have empathy, that is to empathize with the people they're doing the design for. They need to be able to brainstorm in teams, and they need to be willing to initiate solutions and initiate the solutions in a way that they can prototype for outcomes. They said to us, in 5 different ways, they said to us that this space needs to be a place where we are creating the experience of community through the architecture, through the trails, through the activities, through the plazas and the streets, and the way it's designed, a sense of community where people can come together and as one, where they want to live, work, and play. We created the safe space for all of those citizens, the 27 who participated, that vessel, that strong vessel, for them to come and have the messy discussions, to come up with their vision, their recommendation for this area. And that's what we can do for you.